And here we are in Lanzarote, in the Canary Islands, and I'm going to give you an introduction in a moment. What I was going to do now is have a quick go at a sunset, but unfortunately the mist has come up and the sun's disappeared behind it. But anyway, just for fun, I'm going to have a quick go with a pastel without any sun. This is gone behind the layers of mist in the background. Just to show what we can do, even with a softer light, if with pastels on ongrous paper, very fast one, about 10 minutes, just to capture the mood and the light and the atmosphere. A bit of the waves in the foreground and some rather nice little posts and ropes going down. That's it. We're going to have a quick go. Look at the composition first. Very fast composition. On ongrous paper, lock and blending. And really, what more do we need? We just capture that in a few minutes, just to capture a certain light and an atmosphere. The sun isn't there anyway now. Much more than
off.
Yep. So here we are, Canary Islands, Lanzarote. In the first day or so it could have been called Lanzagrotti, it was so grey, but look at the weather now, changed, gorgeous, beautiful. Hear the waves in the background. Although I haven't got my easel and stuff with me, we're going to have a go at trying a little watercolour here of a typical postcard type view. Should be fun. Beautiful weather today, it's nice sun. Give it a go, eh? What we can do, I'm going to use a mop and a small round, and I'm not going to use masking fluid. I've only done the basics of the drawing. I haven't done a very detailed drawing, neither have I made it that accurate. It's just to get a feeling of the place, really. So what I want to do first is get a nice wash down. And I'm using these Russian watercolours today. Not used them before. We'll see how they work. new brush, so we've got bits of fur coming out of my brush, which is really helpful. Get off of that. And I want to get a very light feeling of lights against darks. So I'm going to make the sky much darker than I normally would do to bring the whites of the buildings out in a moment. A bit warmer down here. I haven't got the colours that I would normally use, so now I've straightened the colours up a bit. Remember that watercolour always dries lighter than when you put it on. Painting it at an angle so that the watercolour drops down. I want to put a bit more pink into that, so I'm trying new colours out here. I haven't used this set before, so it's quite interesting for me to blend these and use them. And we want this lovely colour going on down in the sea as well, so we'll drag that through here now as well. I'm going to do a bit of dry brush work there, just to get the feeling of sparkling of the water, just let the water sparkle through there, just by dragging the brush across. And leave it alone. White for the waves going on here. Keep it clean, simple. Take some lemon yellow now and pop it in up here. That could be sunlight effects of some of these palm trees coming in. Let it glow down through. It's lifting up the paper underneath, and we're getting this lovely effect of the sunlight over the palms. So I've got my little mixing palette here, bring that across. I'll put it up on one of the rock ledges nearby for fun, and I can just mix some colours up there. Oh God, I'm just splattered my painting, damn it. I just managed to ruin the sky by splattering my painting, so put a second wash on to bring it back. So we're now seeing how we might be able to bring the painting back if it goes wrong. We've still got those marks that the water has made. It's not going to forgive me. But we'll see what we can do. There's some hills in the background there. And that building's going down to the wall here. We start to feel where the sandy areas are closer down. There's a nice little sandy area just up underneath the umbrella here. By using little touches of paint here and there just to indicate, just to get an impression of the place. And try and bring this out. Lovely colours in the rocks here, some of them stronger, warmer, some of them more yellow. figures down on the side here. Play around with a few. People fishing down here. Done for the study I want to do, I think. Study. Oh, what did you do for now? Quick study. never do it.
Let's get it study.
Ready?
Yeah.
Oh, with no pencil this time, can't find it, so I'm having to do a light drawing in a watercolour wash, first of all. And I've got to move the composition a little bit to try and get everything in that I want to get in. Right, so we'll go from there. Take the wash brush. Right. I'm used to something there. Can't be helped. And I'm going to give it a thin coat of yellow ochre first. Don't leave all the sky. Because it's a dull day, it's almost like a Scottish day, even though it's nice and warm. It's not the bright blue Mediterranean blues today, I'm afraid. So wetting the whole paper with a thin coat of yellow ochre, just to get some colour into the sky first, and then we'll drop in some blue greys. Right, now, start to drop in some blue greys. We'll make that with blue and brown. Just drop in these and let them float out, make them a bit stronger in a minute. Just tickle them in and let them drop down to get this blue-grey sky today. Warmer in places than others. And you can let it just drop down with the wet paper so that it gives a feeling of almost rain coming in. Right down through here. Then I want to go slightly green, just slightly. Here to a very light clouds down there, just tickling along. A bit stronger now with the greys. That gives us our nice soft sky. Let that dry down a bit. We'll start to work into the distance here. Let's look at the sea next. You've got the same sort of colours going on in the sea. Drag that through here. Even drop a little bit of yellow in. And, there's a little bit of beach up here, so we'll come back to that yellow. A bit warmer. I'm just doing some underpainting now. Look at these distant hills, seems to be dry enough there to do that. I'll mix up a nice warm green brown for that for a minute. Let that dry down a bit. Under here. That's more the blue that I want. A line of rather lovely beach umbrellas coming around here that I'll put in nice and wet into wet along here. There's buildings down here indicating. Lovely plant life coming down through the stones here I want to drop in. sun has suddenly come out and changed everything, but we'll still carry on. I'll use a bit of white gouache now, just to finish off. But my water isn't so filthy it doesn't work. And I'll just bring in a few bits of white water. And the veggies. Building back here, they just keep building back in again. As the sun's come out, the whites have got a bit lighter, so I can put them back in just a fraction here. And I think that'll about do it. It'll do it, won't it? Sign it, please. Right, that it will. Thank you.
drink?
Yes, thanks.
I'll just move the handbag for a minute.